no business, like no business, like no business I know. Everything about it is killing, everything that traffic will allow.
Hello. Wow, people. Wow. Social distancing. 6 inches apart. We've come a long way. What was that, your cardboard people? Okay, you're making a lot of noise for cardboard people. Anyway, we are the Curtain Time Players, and we got a good one for you tonight. Okay, a couple of announcements beforehand. Did everyone sign their ticket? If you didn't, please do, because we're going to have a little drawing for a beautiful prize. Did everyone get their ticket signed? Did our flight attendants collect them? Girls? We did? All right, so in a little while we're going to do a drawing. Well, it's really nice to be back, and we're back. And, you know, this COVID or coronavirus, whatever you want, it's been a hell of a year, okay? And, you know, I learned a lot of things this year and the social distancing and all that. And whoever thought that I wouldn't touch her with a 10-foot pole would be a national policy. Okay. And then, of course, there's the people that went out and hoarded 150 rolls of toilet paper. And my thinking is that if they need that much toilet paper, they should have been to a doctor a lot before the coronavirus. Well, we tried to follow all the rules of the health officials, and you know, they said you want to go out to the store, the grocery store, you should wear your face mask. And I did. I went to the grocery store, and everyone else had their clothes on. All right, that's enough, right? Okay. Reminder, after the show is over, please leave the tablecloths in place because we're on a tight budget and we're going to try and use them again if we could. So if you spill your drink, all right, we'll hold you responsible. A couple events that are coming up that we're going to be doing. This month, or August, I should say, we're going to start on our fall plays. Our fall plays are October 22nd and 23rd, Friday and Saturday night in the fall, last weekend, I guess, before Halloween. Anyway, we're going to do two shows, Cheating Death and Nobody to Murder. Now, these are published plays, and let me give you a little bit of heads up. Cheating Death is the angel of death visits a mental hospital to collect someone on his list. This is a one-group therapy session, and you don't want to miss it. This will be the first half of the show. Second half of the show will be a completely different play. Nobody to Murder. Severe thunderstorms and an escaped convict threatens the guest at the Come On Inn. This one is filled with zany characters and hilarious stage action. You can take a look at these plays. You can, there's a website, www.pioneerdrama.com. You can get a sample of it. Most importantly, we're having auditions for this show on August 16th, which is a Monday, in the main hall from 3:30 to 5:30. Anyone can come out. It's not just our Curtain Time Players. We're always looking for new people. Okay, so come out. You know, you want to be on stage, here's your chance. Okay, there'll be plenty of parts for people out there. You can show your talents, or if you don't, we'll teach you. Coming up in the fall, also, is our Wine and Cheese Extravaganza in October. Kind of like a meet and greet and get together. You know, we're here, we have wine, we got cheese, we got snacks. You can check out some videos that we have of our previous performances and whatnot. And it's all done in the middle week of October. The date hasn't not been set yet, but it will be in the newsletter, so you can take a look at that. And please come, it's a fun day. And it's free wine and free cheese and other refreshments, in any event. Our Christmas skit, we do a little Christmas skit every year. For the tree lighting ceremony, which is early in September, December. And we missed it last year because of what was going on, but we'll be back in action for a Christmas skit. Moving on into 2022, Our big show in February, it'll be February 25th and 26th. This is going to be an original. It will be right here on our stage. It's going to be a class reunion of Rydell High, which is from Greece. Now, this took place in 1962. So keep in mind, these people, this is now 2022, and they're not 18 anymore. Okay, so we're working on that one, and I think it's going to be a good one. Now, we're going to get on to our feature performance, okay, which is a good one tonight. I see some people have not settled to their seats yet. Can you please find your table and sit down? The table number is on the on your ticket. Okay, ladies. Ladies. Don't you have a? Do you collect tickets from these people? Oh boy. Yes. Yeah. Yes.
We are here to audition.
I'm sorry, honey. The auditions are over. Our production is tonight. We're ready to go.
We got all dressed up.
You did? You got dressed up?
Yes.
Oh. And what do you do?
We dance. We are called the Sexy 60s.
All right, you're...
Come on.
All right.
You won't be sorry.
All right. I'll give you just a few minutes. I'll give you a shot. Okay.
All right. Just move it right up.
All right. I'm sorry, folks. I wasn't planning on this, but.
Hey, can we open these curtains? We need some room.
Okay. You need help?
No, we're good.
You're good? What?
Well, hold that. I'll tip you later.
A tip?
Yeah.
Don't take anything.
Yeah, don't look inside.
Be careful with them.
Yeah, don't look inside. We know.
Thanks.
Okay.
We ready, girls?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, it's all right. We'll be all right. Let's have some music.
Remember, but it's alright, alright. Just dance, it's gonna be okay. Gotta do do, just dance. In that liquor game, gotta do do, just dance. It's gonna be okay. Just dance. Wish I could shut my Playboy mouth. Oh, oh, oh. How'd I turn my shirt inside out? Inside out, right?
Leave it alone.
You.
But did you think it was great?
Yeah. We'll call you.
Well, we're going to wait to hear.
Okay. I don't know if I should apologize or. I guess it was fun. Yeah, okay. All right. Well, that's it, folks. That's the show's over. So I hope you enjoyed your time here. Like I said, keep the tablecloths on the tables and whatnot. We gave the tickets away. Is there anything else that we need to do? I don't know. I think actually all I'm doing is wasting time so they get set up back there. So I had another joke, but the first few didn't go over so well. So I'll just save yourself with that. In any event, tonight we have a play called All I Really Know, Need to Know, I learned by being in a bad play. And that is not to say that this is a bad play. It just is going to show you guys out there what we have to go through as actors when we're auditioning, rehearsing, the personalities that we need to deal with while we're doing this. And it gets to be very interesting, and let's give you a good insight to what really goes on. And I hope it doesn't change anybody's mind out there about trying to audition for our next show, okay? Because all these issues that we might come across, we all overcome, and when it's showtime, we do it right. Right now, all I really need to know, I learned by being in a bad play.
Welcome. The question I would like to address in this forum today is, how do we learn in this life? Of course, there is formal education. the august institutes of higher learning are where our finest minds apply themselves to the rigors of how to get into a fraternity and make fake IDs. There are also vocational programs where you can study air conditioning repair and make more money than God. Or you could forget all of that and raise alpacas. However, what I will address in our time here today are life lessons. These are quite significant. For instance, I think we can all agree that if somebody happens to warn you a pot is hot,
watch it. This is hot.
It doesn't quite make the same impact as if you touch that same pot and burn your hand.
Ow!
See? That's a lesson with bite. That's one you'll never forget.
Oh, that's really hot.
Another lesson. There are certain kinds of people who never learn.
I'm gonna lick it.
As I was saying, there are certain people who never learn. We call them actors.
Yes, yes, thank you, thank you. Wonderful, yes, because of you, yeah.
Yes, so the point I will make to you today is that theater happens to be a place where we learn many life lessons. Or, in other words,
all I really need to know, I learned by being in a bad play.
Yes, and now...
all I really need to know, I learned by being in a bad play.
Yes, I believe they heard you. So, let's move on and...
all I really need to know, I learned from... oh, flat, yeah.
Yes. So how does a bad play begin?
With a train wreck.
With a bunch of monkeys running around loose.
With a Ferris wheel on fire.
With a narrator.
Yeah, that's one way.
Boy, there's some stinky plays with a narrator.
What a lame device. Like, they come out all, you know, stuffy. And they probably stand in front of a podium. How do we learn in this life? Blah.
Ahem. Anybody with sense knows that a bad play begins with a bad director. I said a bad play begins with a bad director.
Oh, sorry.
Here's our director. The director is never happy. Directors, as a rule, prefer to suffer for their art, which is a good thing because that's exactly what they do, suffer. They also wear a beret.
Now, wait a minute, I look stupid wearing that.
Tough cookies. Ever since early man performed the rudimentary choral odes and dialogues that would form the basis of the very first plays, the idea of theater was to communicate man's condition to his fellow man, to have an honest reflection of what it is like to live on the earth at this point in time. What's interesting is how each play, since that time, has begun with a series of big, fat lies. The first lie is called the audition. Now, to make it easier for you, the audience, to understand what is going on during this audition, we will allow you to hear what both the director and the actor are thinking. This will be accomplished by giving you access to the director's inner voice. And the actor's inner voice. Let us begin.
Hello, I'm the director. Thank you so much for auditioning.
Show, I just knew I had to audition.
Cast me, cast me, cast me.
Oh, great. What will you be doing for us today?
Oh, please don't let it be Blanche from A Streetcar Named Desire. vocal warm-ups so he'll see how professional I am.
May me mama moo. May me mama moo. May me mama moo.
Cast me mama moo. Cast me mama moo. Cast me mama moo. Kill me now.
Okay, we ready?
I already know you're only appropriate for a palace bard.
Sure.
Oh, this is going great. He seems to really like what I'm doing.
I wonder if there's any roast beef left in the house.
Now I'm really gonna wow him.
Do not pound the floor.
Behold, as I pound the floor.
All right, Street, time to wrap it up.
Oh, I'm getting near the end. I need to have a really big finish. Hey, is he yawning? Is he checking his watch? Hey, is he doing his taxes?
That's it.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Sure, not a problem.
That was interesting.
Oh, okay.
Interesting. Oh my God, did you hear that? He said interesting. He wouldn't say interesting unless he loved me. He's going to cast me, probably in the lead. Yes, he'll give me the lead and the great character part. Double cast. Wow, that's a bold move. I think it was the pounding on the floor that sold him. He said interesting.
You know, I have a few more minutes I could do.
Oh, I could do more interesting.
I'd rather be chewed on by rabid dogs.
Well, I'd like to hear more, but you know, there's so many people waiting to audition.
You don't want more interesting?
Well, I remember in your bio you said if you weren't cast, you know, that you'd be willing to be a stage manager.
Well, yes, but you said.
So yeah, great. Oh, great. We'll be in touch, babe. Okay, who's next?
Stage manager.
So, as you can see, the audition process is...
Hey, that wasn't really nice.
Your point?
That was not nice to show the actor up here acting her heart out while the director is worried about roast beef. What kind of lesson is that? That the theater is cruel and life is unfair?
Yes.
You sure are a mean old narrator.
I am only explicating the lessons that come from being in a less than good play.
I will have you know it's quite traumatic to audition standing on stage all by yourself. Your heart is in your throat, and you feel like you've been chewing sawdust. And after that, you go through all the stress and anxiety of waiting to hear. Oh, did you go to the lobby? Is the cast list out?
Yes, there's a piece of paper up there.
And
it's just some kind of security notice about a murderer loose on campus.
Oh, why is this taking forever?
Yeah, it's like a glacier.
Yeah. I'm cold, too.
Oh, no, Flapjack.
I got the cast list. Here it is. Here it is.
It's my purse.
Look, I get it.
Romeo, so wait.
Juliet, awesome.
I'm a Capulet.
How am I to you?
House guard number 5.
To be cast in a small role can scar a person.
You can't always get over it by eating a lot of pancakes.
Sometimes you just need professional help.
guess it's all right to go ahead and get started. Excuse me. In the back if you want something to drink, and we also have donut holes.
Aren't there any regular sized donuts?
No. The purpose of the Small Pot Support Group is to come together in a safe environment to talk about the shame we all feel in being cast in ridiculously small roles. Who would like to share first?
Hi, my name's Samantha.
Hi, Samantha.
I wasn't sure I'd be able to come here today. This is really embarrassing. But I was cast as...
Now go ahead, you're among other actors who have had absurdly small roles.
In a school production about tooth decay. I was cast as a piece of celery.
Oh, dear.
The lead part was a tooth with a cavity. That was a great part. That tooth got to sing a song and cry about being pulled.
Oh, well, we appreciate the courage it takes to share this. Oh, my goodness.
Did you have any lines?
One.
What was it? How many words was it?
I don't remember all of them. Right?
Sure you do. Come on. How many words was it?
Six. Only six. The toothbrush had a whole page and got to sing a song.
Oh, come on. I'm sorry, but that was not really a small role.
Now, Barbara, this is Samantha's first time.
What was the line?
Train your teeth to chew, chew, chew me.
That's eight words. That is not a small rope.
I was celery.
I agree with Barbara. I'm Kelly, and I was cast as a shadow.
Oh.
Train your teeth to chew, chew, chew me. Well, I could have made that celery the hit of the show.
Now.
My costume was a cardboard box in green spray paint.
Do you think a shadow says anything?
No. Or you know you could make it dramatic, like train your teeth to chew, chew, chew me.
What about me? I was cast as a question mark.
There are no small roles, only small actors. That's right, there are no small roles, because every cast member is important. We cannot forget that. Every cast member can contribute to the overall success of the... Oh my, look at the time. Well, you know, we have certainly had a productive session, and I have no doubt that we would make even more progress if we could continue. But, unfortunately, the next group, actors upstaged by babies, needs the space. So let's go.
Hey, somebody ate all our donut holes.
Oh, now, come on. Clear out. Let's move it.
strain your teeth to chew, chew, chew.
Yes, that's enough. So, now that the play has been cast with all manner of basket cases, spastic geeks, and drama queens, it falls to the director to pull together the creative energy of the cast and crew and make their life miserable with crazy ideas.
Wait, hold on. It's not time for the director.
What is it now?
We have to do our warm-up exercises.
Yeah, just like our instruments. We have to tune our instruments, just like an orchestra. And in this case, it's our bodies and our voices. Just like an orchestra would do right before a performance.
La, 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 la.
This is me, and I am here. This is me, and I am here. This is me, and I am here.
Do you honestly believe that this will help your performance?
Yes, it is essential. We cannot perform without it.
There's a wall over there. Ah! No, it's over there. Ah! There is one. It's right there.
Ah! All right, yes, yes. Thank you, darling. Please move along. All right, actors. Shall we gather? Gather, gather, gather.
This is me, and I am here. Oh, Fat Jack.
Yes. Please focus on me as we continue with our warm-ups. We shall begin, as always, by finding our center. Where is our center? It is not on the left, nor on the right, nor on the top, nor on the bottom. Our center is mass. No. Somewhere in the middle region or area of our person. And now we are centerized. Please pick up that baggage you have accumulated before we walk out on the sacred stage. Pick up that heavy baggage from those credit card companies harassing you for a late payment. Or that boyfriend that gave you brown roses he bought at a gas station for your birthday present, after you spent weeks shopping for his expensive suit that molders in the closet, while he, yes, wears a ketchup-stained t-shirt. The big fat idiot. So stuff that baggage down into a steam trunk. Push it down. Lock the trunk. And throw away the key. Yes. And now, let's all pretend that we are a piece of bacon. Yes. We are all bacon on a hot grill. And the heat is making us curl at our ends.
Can I please be a piece of turkey bacon? It's a lot healthier.
Yeah, I'm a vegan. Can't I be a bran muffin?
How can you be a bran muffin?
Like this.
Oh, forget it.
So, are we all completely warmed up? Pretend to be bacon. That was a complete waste of time. The point of this, as I apparently need to remind you all, is...
All I really need to know, I learned by being in a bad play.
Yes, thank you. So now, let's move on to...
All I really need to know, I learned by being in a bad play.
It is amazing to me that some of you can even tie your own shoes.
I have Velcro.
Incredible. As I was saying, the director is who I'd like to talk about now. The director. Yes, come on out. That's it. It's okay. Don't be frightened.
Whoa there! It is not time for the director.
What?
Out! Get out! I'll call you when it's time.
Very clearly, there's a breakdown of communication, which, as we all know, leads to...
You, shut your cake hole. You, go on, get out. I'll call you out in a minute. Go!
Hi. I'm Terry, the stage manager for this show. As your stage manager, I will do all the grunt work, because unlike the rest of you, I wasn't fortunate enough to be cast in a real role. What this means is that I resent you all very much, and during the course of rehearsal, I will yell and scream at you for trivial matters for no particular reason whatsoever. I happen to already be passive-aggressive, and being forced to watch you all perform and get all the praise and attention that should rightfully go to me will only make it worse. Now, where is Juliet?
I'm right here. Yes.
I really wanted your role. And I'm going to be particularly hard on you, especially if you can't learn your lines. And because everybody knows you have the IQ of a squirrel, you're going to have trouble. And that will make me happy for a little bit. But really, you should be careful about anything I give you.
Well, you gave me this cup of coffee.
Don't drink it. Seriously. So you can jump start your car, or ordering you flowers for opening night so it makes it look like people love you. Everybody knows that actors are petty, vain, selfish, and neurotic. And I know you all won't let me down.
You're still going to have the cast party too, right?
All right, yeah. Thanks for reminding me. As a reward, when this play is over, for all my unrecognized and unappreciated hard work, I'll have the cast party. And you all will come over to my apartment and completely trash it. Yeah! So, I'm really looking forward to working with all of you. So let's have a great show, okay? All right, now, the director, who has no business being around sharp instruments, much less leading a pathetic cast of no talent hacks like you all, will come out and say a few words. Director, yo!
No, I'm not going out there. No.
Don't be such a chicken.
Well, okay. The cast is all gathered here. Excellent. That's excellent. And you all know that I'm your director, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Which means that I'm the one responsible for pulling this show together. But what it really means is if this thing lays a big egg, I'm the one everybody's going to blame. So, you know, let's talk about this show we're going to do together, shall we? I've been up all night. I didn't sleep at all, really, except for a little bit when I was driving over here. I've been up reading and rereading and going over the concept, you know, the unifying idea that'll pull this turkey together. Did you know that there's a Starbucks open all night now, real close to here? Yeah, and you can go like at 2 a.m. for real and have like 10 espressos, and nobody's going to stop you. They're not going to cut you off or anything, because it's not illegal. I mean, you can just keep on drinking and ordering and drinking, even if you start to think that there's bats nesting in your hair. Yeah. Oh, my God. Whoa. Why did I ever decide to do this play? It's like a puzzle written backwards in Sanskrit. Oh, my God. One thing I do know for sure, though, our costumes should be garbage bags and top hats.
What? Is that what Juliet wears?
Oh, did I mention our play's going to be set on Mars?
Mars.
Okay. Thank you, director.
Mars? Okay, actors. Stop daydreaming about how pretty you are and listen up. First rehearsal is tomorrow night. Let's not be late or I'll make fun of you all night.
Who let all these bats in here?
Please go take a nap.
Nap? I gotta rehearse tonight and I need more coffee. Oh my God, I'm out. Not a drop, not a dram. Whoa, he's decaffeinated me. I gotta have more coffee. More. Oh look, there's more coffee over there by the bats. Yeah, coffee, coffee, coffee!
All right then, we've made it to rehearsals. A most crucial time in the development of our play. A time when our theatrical artists apply their vast skill and knowledge to avoid rehearsing the play. The lesson here is fairly straightforward. Whatever you do, don't be the last person without an excuse.
Stage manager, you're in charge of many things, right? The most important task you're gonna have is to keep me away from the coffee. No matter how much I beg and plead, you got it?
Fine.
All right. I'd like to begin by doing the balcony scene. Can you round up Romeo and Juliet for me?
Nope.
Well, where's Romeo?
Jury duty. Back tomorrow.
Okay, we'll start with Juliet's scenes.
How's the rash?
Rash?
Yeah, somebody apparently rubbed poison ivy all over her script. I don't know who that could have been.
Well, how about the nurse?
Religious holiday. Which is funny because she's not religious.
Well, Tybalt.
Oh, he's here.
Oh, good.
But he had his wisdom teeth taken out.
I'm here.
Oh, forget it. Go home, Tybalt. How about Mercutio?
Scurvy.
Scurvy? I thought that was something only pirates got. Oh, God. Well, what about Friar Lawrence?
Friar Lawrence. Yeah. Oh, yeah. This is interesting. So, Friar Lawrence is in his apartment, and he's trying to peel an orange. And he gets some juice in his eye. So there he is, stumbling around his apartment, trying to get the juice out of his eye, looking for a towel, and he steps on a jellyfish. You see, his roommate had brought the jellyfish back from the beach, but his roommate is a complete slob, totally forgetful, and he left it in a bucket on the floor in the kitchen. And poor Friar Lawrence, blind from the juice in his eye, steps in the bucket and the jellyfish stings his foot. So, he goes to the hospital and they're like, what? You got some pulp in your eye and a jellyfish bite on your toe? Big whoop, cry me a river. And they send him home.
Oh, well, good. So he's here.
No, his grandmother died. He's at the funeral.
Terry, look. Is anybody here? I mean, we can't have a play unless we rehearse, and we can't rehearse when all the cast has got scurvy or a lockjaw or whatever. Get me one actor, one warm body, and we can get something done tonight.
This is me, and I am here. This is me. And I am here. This is me, and I am here.
cancel rehearsal. We'll pick it up again tomorrow night, same time.
Sounds good.
Eventually, the actors run out of fake diseases and dead grandmothers, and rehearsals begin. Rehearsals are a time when the cast and crew come together to work on the play. Night after night, they practice monologues and perform the same scene over and over again. If you've ever taken a long ride on a hot bus headed to the insane asylum, then you know what rehearsals are like. But during the course of rehearsal, we have learned several things. The main thing we have learned is that time is our friend and then our enemy.
Hold on. Time is our friend and then our enemy?
You'll see.
You sure are a weird, obscure narrator.
Anybody seen the stage manager?
Hey, everybody listen. The posters for the show are here. Please pick several up and put them up wherever you can. These posters are one of the main ways we advertise our show. Posters right here.
I was here for 3 hours last night and we never got to my part. I fell asleep on the floor in the back.
Yeah, we could all hear you snoring.
Good citizens, has anyone spied my fair Juliet? You mean Kathy?
I believe she went on down to yon water fountain.
Hey, what's the matter with the director?
What do you mean?
Well, I had a brand new cup of coffee. He grabbed it out of my hand and ran away. He stole my coffee!
Oh my God, which way did he go?
That way.
Romeo,
what's thou, my Romeo? Has any of y'all seen Romeo?
His cell phone worketh not. He hide himself to parking lot to get it better signal.
Wondering why this play is set on Mars.
Did you hear? It's not on Mars anymore.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, the director changed it last night. It's now set during the Civil War.
Who's in charge of props? This sword is too small.
Do you know what part we're working on tonight?
Act one.
Act one? I don't come on until act five.
Well, you still gotta be here.
When are we going to get to Act 5?
We'll get there eventually. We don't open for 4 weeks.
No, 3.5.
No, I thought it was 4.
Well, still, 3.5 weeks. That's plenty of time.
Oh, I don't know.
Okay, the posters for the show are still here. Actors, are you listening? It doesn't matter to me if nobody comes and sees this show. I won't be on stage, but you will. Get a poster, put it up, so people will come and watch you butcher whatever role you're in.
And what's the story on the set?
Well, what do you mean?
Well, normally we'd have one at this point.
I'd bite my thumb
you.
Oh, the director keeps changing his mind. Now the plays can be set in a Starbucks.
I find my thumb at you.
Starbucks.
Speak it to me, not.
Juliet, wait. That text was meant for someone else. I said LOL. LOL.
I find my thumb at you.
Stronger. Needs to be much stronger. It's much too weak.
Are you talking about my performance?
No, I'm talking about my coffee.
Oh, hey, look, Terry's over there.
Oh, God.
Hey, is anybody else having, like, dreams?
Dreams?
Well, yeah, I keep having this dream that I may be a little bit late for rehearsals, you know, and I show up and the stage is empty and someone tells me that the show is over.
But it's just a dream, right?
Yeah, but it's so real, it's like freaking me out.
Can someone help me get a smaller sword?
Hey, where were you last night?
I was home.
Home? We had rehearsal. Oh, the director is really upset with you.
Where's the director? I didn't know.
I'm not anywhere close to remembering my lines.
It's okay. We've got 3 weeks before we open.
Two. We've got 2 weeks.
Two weeks? Really?
Yep, 2 weeks.
Oh, that makes my stomach hurt. Oh, that's so
good. Uh-huh. Cast and crew, listen up! The posters for the show are still here! Right here where I left them when we started rehearsal. Are you just hoping a big audience wanders by and decides to drop everything and come see the show? Guess what? That won't happen. Get a poster, put it up now!
Yeah, she's wound up, isn't she? This sword won't work. We're doing Romeo and Juliet, and this is a lightsaber.
Can someone find me a decent sword?
May the force be with you.
Thank you.
Everybody is stressed out.
That does seem a little over the top.
No, it's not over the top. The director is over-caffeinated. Oh, dear, the poor director.
Well, first it was set on Mars.
Yes, and then
the Civil War.
Then the Civil War, and now it's in Starbucks, and poor Friar Lawrence, he's walking around still moaning and groaning about his jellyfish bite. Romeo and Juliet, they split up, and all they do is text one another instead of doing their rehearsal time about how much they hate each other.
And the costumes? Are just weird. This has been a stressful rehearsal.
All you can do is control your part. Learn what you're supposed to do and feel confident about that. Everything will take care of itself.
And this is true.
You know, I've been here night after night, and I still don't know who you are. What part do you play?
I don't. I'm an usher.
For heaven's sake. We're not doing the play tonight. There won't even be an audience.
Well, I know I came early to practice. Would you like a program? 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 Would you like a program?
Know your lines yet?
Yeah, I know them at home, but here on the stage is another story.
Hey, how's it going?
Oh, it's good. You know, I stopped having those dreams.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, you know, I think it was just anxiety on my part, you know? I mean, but, you know,
now that I had enough rehearsals and I got my lines down cold and I know where I'm supposed to be, dreams have gone away, you know? And I feel good. Everything's just going to be okay.
You do know you're not wearing any pants, right?
Oh, God!
This place is totally insane. Good thing we've got some time before the show opens.
No kidding. Yeah, we still have a week, right?
A week?
Okay, 5 days.
No.
3 days.
The play opens tomorrow night. Lesson for me? What would that be?
It is not right for you to judge and think you're smarter than all these people who are just trying to do their best. My name is Kay, and this is the first play that I've ever been in. I never thought I'd make it through tryouts. I got so scared, I was shaking. But I got a part. I know that is so exciting. And it's a little part, but I don't care because I love it here. I love those weird warm-up exercises. Oh, and I love being bacon. I love the fact that I have a script with my name on it. I carry it everywhere I go. I even sleep with it under my pillow. Now, I've got 3 lines, and we have to rehearse every scene over and over and over again, which is just great, because that means I get to be here instead of having to go and do all those strange things that my friends want to do. You know, the people here, they're so goofy and they're nice and they care about me. So, what if it is a bad play? I have learned so much. There's upstage and there's downstage, and I've learned that I like it better here than going home to visit my parents who never speak. And I like it better here than going to school where people think I'm weird. I love being in this play, Mr. Narrator, and I'm going to do this the rest of my life. I mean it, for the rest of my life.
Well, I think your point is well taken. However, I would like to make the counter-argument that...
Actors, places! 5 minutes in the curtain! Oh, let's get this disaster underway! 5 minutes!
Good show, everybody.
God,
show.
Here we go again.
I'm not ready. I need more rehearsal.
5 minutes!
Come, night. Come, Romeo. come thou day and night, for thou wilt lie upon the wings of night, whiter than new snow on a raven's back. Come, gentle night, come, loving black-browed night, give me my Romeo, and when he shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars, and he will make the face of heaven so fine that all the world will be in love with night and pay no worship to the garish sun. Oh, I have bought the mansion of a love, though not possessed it, and though I am sold, not yet enjoyed. So tedious is this night, as is the night before some festival, to an impatient child that hath new robes and may not wear them. Just wait for the next audition. 2 minutes to curtain, places, 2 minutes.
There you have it. Now our truly wretched evening of theater is over. Lines were forgotten. Props were misplaced and dropped. The lights went down when they should have gone up. Yes, we get it. Thank you. And still, even though the audience has suffered through hours of ineptitude and gotten leg cramps and unwrapped little candies that sounded like somebody tearing into a huge Christmas present, they haven't learned a thing. Because when the lights go down for the final time...
Where's Romeo and Juliet? They need to bow. Trying to let you go first.
Oh, what? So you can go last? No, thank you.
I'm only trying to be polite.
Oh, you were just impossible.
Me?
Excuse me.
Hands up.
So, we have come to the end of our lesson. Is anyone wiser? I believe we have answered our own question.
Hey, aren't you coming to the cast party?
Me? I didn't know I was invited.
You were in the play, weren't you?
Well, you know, I've always felt there was something to be ascertained by studying the post-performance celebration, particularly the rituals involved in the games played.
If you keep on talking, it'll be over with by the time we get there.
Yes, so let's hustle.
Let's hustle.
Slapjack.
There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is killing, everything that traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are alone. Yesterday they told you you could not go far. That night you opened, and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they throw a star. Let's go on with the show. There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything that traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you are stealing.